ABC's College Football, brought to you by Today Chevrolet, who invites you to see why more people are winning with the heartbeat of America. And by AC Delco Automotive Parts. AC Delco, it's like buying time.
Big Ten football and the conference leader, the Hawkeyes of Iowa. 5-0 and ahead of Ohio State by a field goal with Jeff Skillet kicking it off. And Lee, 1 yard deep, elects to come out and he slips. Then finds an alley. And he's out of bounds on the far side. Mark Jones, I know you spoke to Coach Cooper. What was he so angry about? What's the story from the first half?
Well, guys, he was upset about a couple of things. First of all, he was upset that he was whistled for a personal foul call. He felt that the referee shouldn't have stopped the clock for the first down measurement when it was obvious it wasn't even close to a first down before the half ended. Second of all, Cooper's upset that the referees won't stop the clock and give Greg Fry a chance to quiet down the crowd. The referee's upset at him right now, and obviously he's not on the referee's Christmas card list either.
Yeah, I would say not. First and 10 for Fry and the Buckeyes, down by a field goal as we get underway here in the second half. Freshman Robert Smith back in, and that's his best run from scrimmage. 11 yards right straight up the middle behind the offensive line.
Yeah, and a real good trap block by the big strong guard, John Peterson, number 75, came around. You'll see this coming from the end zone here, what I'm talking about. He does a real nice job of coming around here and trapping as they seal off inside. Watch this now, Peterson, there he goes. Now watch him kick out. Oh, he actually turns up inside and gets his block. Really a good job, good read on his part. You know, the irony of the whole thing, Brent, if they hadn't had that stop the clock before the half, they wouldn't have had enough time to get the big play that they got.
So I guess it balances out. Yeah. First and 10, Fry with the whistle blowing as the ball was snapped.
There is a penalty marker on the play.
So the officials were busy in the first half, and they start out that way here in the second half.
Illegal procedure, Ohio State.
Coach Cooper won't be happy about that one, but he seems to be in agreement over there on the far side.
Dead ball. Dead ball. Ball start.
Robert Smith starting to run with some of the greats of college football. There's his average compared to Dorsett, Walker, Smith, but ahead of Anderson. Thought about the name of Walter Payton. And today, 42 more yards with 7 carries. Closing in on that freshman record at Ohio State established by Archie Griffin. The option fly, late pitch, very dangerous. On the bounce, Smith was able to pick it up. Ooh, that was close, wasn't it?
You see, when you run an option play to the split inside of the formation, you get quicker pressure here from the outside linebacker. If you run it to the tight end, it's a little longer situation. See, and he gets there right now. He got there really quick. Got to pitch that much quicker in that situation, especially to the split inside of the formation.
Gary Clark coming over to bring him down. Fry with both backs out, steps up against the pressure. Almost intercepted at midfield by Clark.
Whew. That was close. Gary Clark, number 19, almost had the big play of the afternoon. Sprinting away, setting up away from the main part of the rush. He moves back up inside. He fires it under pressure. And, Brent, this is why sometimes quarterback pressure is more valuable than a quarterback sack. The sack, he can't throw the ball. Pressure, he can throw it. You get the interception. Many times you can take it back and score.
Inside of 5 seconds on that 25-second clock, so Fry has to use a timeout. Things are not going Ohio State's way. Just 1 second left on the 25-second clock, and Ohio State uses one of its 3 second-half timeouts. Iowa 17, Ohio State 14, 13:26 to go in the third, and this is the drive chart for Ohio State in the first half, Coach.
Yeah, punt, the long drive for the touchdown, and you see the other long drive for the touchdown. This one right here is the batted ball. That's the lucky play. The other long drive was the executed play. They need more of those executed drives.
It was fourth and goal that they scored on the first one. Here it is, third and 15 for the Buckeyes. drive comes in motion.
Try to go deep. He's got Graham. Incomplete at the 25-yard line.
We're looking for another ricochet reception.
I think Graham actually outran Greg Pry's strength in his arm. If he'd have thrown the ball a little sooner, he might have been able to complete that, because Graham was down between the two defenders in the zone. It just took a little too much time to get this one down there. You'll see it coming down right now. But Graham had two or three steps on him. Then he went back for the ball, and the defenders caught up with him.
Bowman standing inside the Buckeye 25-yard line. Two Ohio State punts blocked this year. Good block by Clark. One off the Hawkeye, and Antula steals it at the 20. Beautiful. Out to the 34-yard line. He got all he could on that before Lance Price brought him down. 14-yard return and a nifty one after a 43-yard punt. Hawkeye's first possession here of the second half.
The Hawkeyes have been a very efficient offensive team in the second half. They're the second-leading third-scoring team in the Big Ten, and the second-leading scoring team in the fourth quarter. Equivalence to or adds up to being the number one scoring second-half team. You really better lock on the chin straps now defensively and try to shut them down in this drive.
Matt Rogers with the visor, quarterbacking the Hawkeyes. Hasn't thrown an interception in a Big Ten game since Wisconsin, I believe. Rogers
to Bell off the fake and going deep to Smith, and almost intercepted.
And he opened for a moment. Mark Pelini, 48, was their defensive.
You said it so clearly. You had him open for a moment. The quarterbacks are waiting too long to throw the deep one. Let it go sooner.
How about the Hawkeyes' drives in the first half, Coach?
Well, you know, they started right off the right way. Eight plays and in the end zone, can't be much better. Then they turn it over, they come back 1, 2, 3 out, but they have been moving the ball. You can see in 3 of the 6 drives, they move the football.
Coming back with a 2nd and 10. Titley, 84, is the tight end. The formation is strong to the quarterback's right. You can see that familiar stand-up tight end, able to watch the secondary a little bit better when he comes out of there. This is Bell. Not much daylight there as he was met by the middle of that line. Tom Lease, 81, leading the defense that time.
You know, I had the feeling in talking to the defensive coaches at Ohio State last night that they felt that they could get after Bell. They felt they could prop him up and tattoo him and slow him down and take some of the confidence that he's been running with out of him. But as a coach, offensive coach, I'd make him prove it to me. I'd give Bell the ball 15 times in the second half. Big horse like that.
He gained 168 yards against Illinois, and here today 11 carries for 56 yards. Rogers with the changeup at the line of scrimmage on 3rd and long. Fakes the run, has time, receiver's covered. Now he'll run out of trouble, and he trips him down at the 39-yard line. Iowa forced the punt, 3 and out.
Good coverage downfield. Had a lot of time, but it doesn't matter how much time you have if you can't find a guy open downfield. And as you said, he isn't going to throw the interception. He's not going to make the dumb move with the ball in his hand.
Jim Hyzak, hunting for Iowa, Coach.
Matt Rogers told me the other day he's starting to like running the football. They're having him run the option, which they haven't done yet today, but they will.
Jeff Graham will feel much more comfortable if this punt is batted.
This guy Graham can really return it.
25, surrounded, now makes a move to the far side, finds an alley. You were right about that. He got back to the 35-yard line and nailed him. Line-wise, getting him out of bounds. An 11-yard return. We'll be right back. Iowa and Foster ahead by 3 points. But last year, this inside linebacker and the rest of the Hawkeyes were embarrassed. 28-0 in Columbus. One of those games that young men don't easily forget. As Fry changes up at the line of scrimmage, brings his fullback, Scotty Graham, John Derby bringing him down. And this is what Foster had to say about his memories in Columbus of a year ago.
28-0. They caught a picture of me and Eddie Polly walking off the field right after the game. And we had taken a look up at the scoreboard, and we saw 28-0, and we shook our head, and we looked at each other and said, that's all right, they're going to be in our house next year.
And in our house right now with Robert Smith back in the backfield. Fly to throw, incomplete, a one-hopper. It'll be third down. Ryan Stabline is the intended receiver.
They're getting good pressure, consistent pressure on Greg Pry, and it's tough to throw the accurate pass. I wouldn't be surprised to see Coletto and Rod Hudson, the quarterback coach, to get him outside the pocket on some kind of a rollout or bootleg action away from the heat. Let's see what Coletto calls.
Third down, 7 yards for Ohio State. First down. Again, the changeup at the line.
They're audibling because of the tight coverage. Now Iowa backs out of the tight coverage.
Fly, receiver covered, comes back the other way and throws incomplete. Great coverage by Hanks over here on Olin.
They're playing games with each other. They showed a tight Red Dog coverage like they were going to come after him. He audibled. They backed out of the coverage and went two deep zone. Didn't have a pattern for a two deep zone call.
And Fry, 0 of 4.
Frustrating.
Defensive coverage this half for the game. 5 of 16 for 106 yards.
You know, I've seen Fry many times in the same situation, Brent, and that 5 of 16, 5 of 16, and all of a sudden he goes 10 straight in a row.
Bowman drives Antula back inside the 15-yard line, bluffing
there.
The fair catch, gets an Ohio State bounce, and the Hawkeyes will be buried on this one back at the six.
Well,
Dr.
Nice
Tom
play.
Davis coaches the Iowa basketball team, and he's downstairs with Mark. Mark?
Thanks a lot, Brent. You know, one of the big stories right now in the Big Ten period, not just football but basketball, is the brewing storm between Iowa and Illinois. Coach, what are your reactions to the Illinois sanctions and penalties?
I think like most other coaches, we're just anxious to get on the court, on the basketball court, and get ready to play. So we're looking forward to that.
Does this add any incentive to your head-to-head competition against Illinois this year?
Well, you know, in this league, the competition's so intense anyway that you don't need much extra incentive. So I just think there'll be good intense rivalries among all the schools.
This will be a big act to follow up if this football team goes to the Rose Bowl.
I'm like every other Hawkeye fan. We're just excited about what's going on.
Thanks a lot for joining us. Brent Zick, back.
Thanks, Mark. That was Nick Bell, the tailback, with the carry there for the Hawkeyes. Second down and 9. Jacksonville, Florida. The Gators beating up on Uga and the Dogs today. Michigan ahead of Illinois. And that would help Iowa's Rose Bowl chances here today. Again, they can clinch a tie if they beat Ohio State, and both Michigan schools also record victories. It's Bell again behind the left side. This will leave them with a third down, and Steve Tovar, 58, was there defensively.
We've talked about Steve earlier, just a sophomore, has great instincts to the ball. Sometimes you take a guy like this and you coach him to a point, then you shut up and let him play. You've got to be careful. You discipline him to a point that you take away some of the spontaneity and instincts in his play.
Two defenses slugging it out here in the early going of the second half. Rodgers incomplete, and that was fine defense by Brent Johnson that time.
That's the second series in a row now. They've gone 1-2-3 and out. Good defense for Ohio State. Bill Young and his defensive coaching staff, Gary Black, Nate Fred Pejak, Ron Zook, done a good job at halftime.
Isaac standing in the Iowa end zone. And Jeff Graham could give the Buckeyes some field position. Low snap, well fielded by Hizak. Good punt considering that snap. Graham fumbles, out of bounds, Ohio State ball. 43-yard punt and out of bounds. Now, what can Ohio State do to change up against this pass coverage that you've been telling us about?
Well, they're bluffing some coverages, all right? They're showing up front, then backing out. First thing I'd do is I'd come up and go in some quick count. Make them show right now what they're going to be in. Line up and go. The other thing I'd do is then I'd start running some motion. Man in motion, and if they chase you man-to-man, then you know you're man-to-man. If they just back off, then you know they're in a zone. Sort of control them that way.
Graham and Smith are the running backs behind Fry. is at the Buckeye 48-yard line. The toss to Smith. And he's hit behind the line of scrimmage. Did not get back as Crane, number 88, who replaced the injured Moses Santos, comes in and makes the stop.
Gary Liktovich, number 86, the tight end, was really mad at himself. It was a one-on-one block situation with him on Crane, and Crane won the battle. You'll see this on the screen right up here. Defender, tight end. See, they're tossing the ball. To toss the ball, you got to get it. Oh, heck, darn near got him lassoed there. He wanted him to go outside. He turned up inside.
As a result, it's second and 11. The draw to Smith. Crosses midfield for the 49-yard line. A reminder that tomorrow on ABC Sports, Yvonne Lindell competes with eight of the world's top stars for $500,000 in total prize money. Tots presents the Tennis Shootout. Coverage begins at 4, 3 Central and Pacific tomorrow on ABC.
Talking about money, it was sort of cute what Coach Fry said to you the other day in the meeting. He said, you know, Brent, you moved to Iowa with all the dough you make, you could afford a three-holer, he said. He nailed you, didn't he?
Those folks who don't come from rural country
don't know what they're talking about.
You're talking about. I'll send them to the dictionary. All right.
Blitz.
Under pressure. Avoids it niftily and throws a wounded duck out of bounds. But he avoided a negative statistic that time by just getting it off.
Well, Bill Brazier, the defensive coordinator, said he wanted to get pressure on the outside of these kinds of passes. He gets it. Now see the pressure, a little play action fake. Here comes the pressure outside, Leroy Smith. Now he has pressure in front of him right there with Johnson, number 71. Forces the bad ball.
Bowman hunting again.
3-3.
Fry is 0-5 passing this half. Iowa leading Ohio State, 17-14. And the Buckeyes will give it back to the Big Ten leader. Tula again signals for the fair catch, and the ball will be downed at the 20-yard line. So we'll take a break and come right back with 7:47 to go in the third. The Iowa fans never dreaming when this season began that they might be headed to Pasadena. Alonzo Spellman with his ankle nicked up a bit, but staying on the field defensively for the Buckeyes. First and 10 for Iowa. They lead it by a field goal. The fullback, Montgomery, breaks away from a tackle and makes his way out to the 28-yard line. We have raved about the two tailbacks, but I'm not so sure that Montgomery hasn't been their most impressive runner in this game.
And I do believe because of the two tailbacks being so successful that people are keying on him and flowing with the tailback, and they're not seeing the fullback right in his face. Now, this is just a real good individual effort. He has that low center of gravity, and he keeps those feet pumping.
Seven carries, 44 yards, and a touchdown. 2 yards for the first down, and Stewart trying to reach out, maybe a little short. Rich Frimmel tackling him for the Buckeyes.
The Ohio State is playing so much better defense than they played a year ago. Bill Young and his staff have done a real good job. They really improved. Last year, they gave up a touchdown every 23 snaps. This year, they've been forcing a team to run 40 snaps before they score. Good improvement, and it will continue to improve because they have a lot of young football players playing.
Third down and less than a yard. It'll be Stewart.
He didn't make it.
He was stuffed right there at the line of scrimmage. Again, the spot will be important here.
Carl Jackson, the offensive coordinator for Iowa, said they wanted to pound on these guys up inside and constrict them. Then it's come with the short passing game, both drop back and play pass, and misdirection. We haven't seen misdirection, but I think it's time to get the ball outside. They've got them constricted inside. Get it outside.
Now, coach, you be the coach again. You're up by three. You've got fourth and very short.
I'd punt it.
Well, you and Hayden agree. Great minds think alike.
No, not in his class. But
you won one more Rose Bowl than he did.
But I think you're better off doing that. The only thing is, this guy, you'll never know what he might do. He might snap at that fullback.
They're trying to draw him offside probably right now. And then they go ahead with the snap. And Hizak punts it.
That's a return.
And Graham at the 30. 35. Down at the 38-yard line where it will be first and 10 for Ohio State. 17-14 is our score right now with 6:09. And in case you just joined us, here's how the scoring went. Matt Rogers, 3 yards for the first touchdown of the game, putting the Hawkeyes up by 7. Greg Fry on first and goal, and we were even. Then it was a skillet field goal. It was 10-7. Daylight, a 10-point lead on Montgomery's run. And just as the half ended, Jeff Graham caught a ricochet, 48 yards, Ohio State touchdown. 17-14 right now, and Fry faking to Smith. Penalty marker is down, incomplete, out of bounds on that far side. We do have a penalty flag. Dick, your feeling about this passing game of Ohio State's right now?
Well, I feel this, Brent. The quarterback is getting down, knocked down too many times, too much pressure on him. And I know that they have a quicker passing game in drop-back design, the three-step drop, the five-step drop. Go back and fire some of those and take some of the heat off the quarterback.
So the holding penalty against Cooper and the Buckeyes.
Holding. Okay.
And the ball will be brought back to the 28-yard line. So it'll be first and 20.
The big thing when you have first and 20 is don't try to get 21 yards on one snap. Be satisfied with 6, 8, that type of thing in design and in your play call.
Olive and Graham to the same side as receivers. Scotty Graham is the fullback in front of Smith. The toss to the freshman. Penalty marker down again.
Number 32.
Right now, I think they sort of miss Ellis at the tight end position because he was the guy, the big physical blocker on the outside linebacker that could block that guy. I'm not too sure the backup tight end can do that. We'll take a look and see if what's happening here. Top of your screen. That's the key block if you're going to run outside. Normally they have a 260-pounder right there, but you see number 88, Crane is controlling that point of attack.
Defense, repeat first down.
Likovich, the tight end who must fill in for Ellis.
He's been playing, you know, prior to this ball game when they were scoring over 47 points a game, so he's been doing a good job. But evidently Crane is a very strong young man at 6'3", 240 pounds.
They go to an extra wide receiver. Edwards and Graham and Stabline. And Fry hands to Scotty Graham, who blasts his way to the 36. Mark, is Coach Cooper upset again on that far sideline?
Well, Brent, Dick, a little more on that feud between Cooper and the referees. He's been complaining about the defense of Iowa lining up in the neutral zone. And ironically, two plays ago, the Iowa defensive line was finally whistled for offside. The feud continues. He's been working the referees big time from the Ohio State sidelines.
Don't think that doesn't influence an official. If you as a coach, because I've done it myself, you're on the sideline, you're in that guy's ear, in that guy's ear, and sooner or later, you're going to get that one called.
5 minutes, third quarter, 17-14, Iowa leading Ohio State. Buckeyes with the ball. Fry picks it back up. Looks for a receiver and throws it away out of bounds.
There again is Mr. Davis. I don't know if he slipped or he stepped forward with one foot and the center's foot got him. That's what happens many times. Take a look right here at the footwork here. Let's see if this quarterback steps forward with one foot. Yes, right there. See him, and he gets stepped on. I'm not sure it wasn't the right guard's inside foot that got him. But that's what happens in that many times. They step forward as they try to pedal out, and then an offensive lineman who's coming back in pass protection steps on his foot.
Fry 0 of 6 this half. Third and 14. Fry straight back. Over the middle, complete to Olive, and a Buckeye first down at Iowa's 45.
Again, what kind of pattern was that? The deep square in. That's their best pattern. They've got to take that away if they want to win this football game. They'll come back with that again. Straight drop back pass. He steps up nicely. There's good pressure on him. Here it is coming right in the middle of the screen. Good catch by Bobby Olive. He gets up there. That's the second time he's going up in the air like that for the ball. And he's another guy that walked on. No scholarship, and he earned a scholarship. Give him credit.
First down for Ohio State. They trail it by three. 4:27 remaining in the third quarter. Smith and a penalty flag comes flying.
What's the penalty now?
Smith gets to the 40.
Illegal motion. He must have been moving toward the line of scrimmage when it was snapped. Boy, I'll tell you, coaching's easy, isn't it? Here he's just off back surgery. He should be in a lawn chair beside his swimming pool. Recuperate.
Look to put your future in the hands of 17, 18, and 19-year-olds.
Hey, I've done it.
And he's working at one of the shrines, Ohio State.
Where the expectation is almost beyond belief. You know, they expect so much at Ohio State because they're spoiled over the years.
Head of high school and college football, isn't it? Fry, handing to Smith. Penalty flag comes flying.
Now what is it? Let him play. You know what happens? What happens? It's self-destructing. It self-destructs you mentally. You get upset, you do something positive and you get the flag. You do something positive and you get the flag. And it drains you mentally as a football team. And as a coach, you about go wild.
Holding. Offense. Repeat first down.
And you could call holding almost on every snap. You look at me, they've got the hands out, they're grabbing people. And I really think they've allowed a little more holding in the Big Ten this year than in past years. And I really do. Let's see if we can find the holding penalty. Let's see, where is it? Where is it? Where is it?
Oh. 52.
Yeah, all right, that's Hartman.
There's no question. This is first and 25. They'll need one of your square ends here. Fry back. Incomplete. He was throwing back on the outside. And the coverage was read differently by Graham.
Graham didn't do a real good job on that. See, he curled around the inside and stopped right behind the defender rather than sliding inside or outside away from the defender. Didn't get in the throwing lane between he and the quarterback. He has too much experience to make that mistake.
Now Robert Smith checks back into the game. Off the draw, the fake. Fry again. Wanted his wide receiver to the outside, so more confusion between quarterback and receiver.
Yeah, but you know what happens? What happens to the quarterback? You've been under pressure, you've been under pressure, you've been under pressure. All of a sudden, you don't have pressure, and you still hurry your throw. You've got to go ahead when you have time, take your time, and make sure you throw the strike. That time, he threw faster than he had to.
Ohio State needs 25 yards for the first down. 3 minutes and 30 seconds remain here. In the third quarter, they need to advance the ball to Iowa's 34-yard line. This is a third down for Fry. Everybody out. Again, pressure. Incomplete, and the Buckeyes are forced to punt.
Good pressure, good pressure. Went full zone coverage down there. No high percentage pass going downfield. Everybody watching the quarterback. Heat, no place to go. Did a good job. Just get rid of it. Coop, he's getting after him. He's fired up.
All our scoring here in the first half. The defenses move center stage in the third quarter.
Nice.
Bowman booms perhaps his best punt of the day. Tula comes up at the 22-yard line, didn't make the fair catch, and downed in his tracks. This is a big night for Twin Peaks on ABC. Let's take a look at what's coming your way on our prime time lineup here tonight.
Where were you in 1970? Colleen McMurphy's on the road, running from herself. China Beach. Then, It was a mystery that captured the imagination of the whole country. And tonight, the killer of Laura Palmer will finally be revealed. Really, Twin Peaks tonight.
Back with first and 10 for the Hawkeyes. Rogers, straight back. Tight end Tintley all alone and out of bounds in Ohio State territory. Vinny Clark forcing him out at the 47-yard line. The great secret weapon in the college game, the tight end, and Tintley gains 28 yards, Coach.
Real good job of the tight end right here. Released, and he got down in the mid zone between a deep pattern and a short pattern. Stretched the zone vertically, and he threw it nicely. He had good time and hit right in between the deep defender and the short defender.
Mike Saunders is into the game as the lone running back.
Watch out for a play-action pass or something fancy when he's in there.
Rogers' receivers are covered that time, and he runs to the 43-yard line. Rich Frimmel credited with that stop.
Mike Saunders is a gimmick guy. When he's in there, you better watch out because he does things. Reverse passes, pitch backs, and this kind of thing.
Saunders back out after that play.
You know, maybe they're setting something up because the old fox over there, he sets it up. What he calls these his fancy plays the exotics, and he always sets them up. Maybe he wanted to see number 32 in the game.
Second down. Draw play with Bell. Cutting back for the first down. Hawkeye first down at the Ohio State 36-yard line.
See, when you have a big back like this, young or not, you still have to hit him with the pads, bend the legs, and strike through him because he has a lot of power. Good draw technique by the quarterback. He took it back. He inserted it. Now, look at the power. See, one man grabbed him there. He didn't get him. One guy hits him there. Look, he's still going forward. Still going forward. 242 pounds, 4.5 40.
Bell is lined up behind Montgomery. And off a fake to Bell.
Wide open, wide open.
Cross number 87.
Play action pass. I think they were in a too deep zone. The play action freezes everybody. And Cross, the tight end, comes down and gets in the hole behind the linebackers. You'll see the fake in there. Linebackers are attacking, playing run. They're on the line of scrimmage. There's a big hole in between the linebackers and the safety. Here comes the safety and does what he has to do.
Phenomenal tight end production here in Iowa City for the Hawkeyes. 21 more yards and a first and 10 at the Ohio State 15-yard line. Fake to Bell, and they bring Montgomery around the right side.
You know, you said fake to Bell. I think it's as the game plan unfolds here in the second half, it's obvious that they're trying to counter always giving the ball to the tailback. They're faking to the tailback and giving it to the fullback. They did it efficiently in the second quarter. They're doing it again here.
A couple of yards. Second down and 8. Mike Saunders goes out as a wide receiver. Montgomery set in front of Bell.
Broken play.
Rogers under pressure, down at the 20-yard line.
Broken play.
Jason Simmons in there on top of the Hawkeye quarterback.
Either the quarterback went the wrong way or the running backs went the wrong way, but somebody was wrong. Take a look from the end zone. You'll note how the running backs go one way and the quarterback goes the other. Now watch this. That's confusing. See, oh, he says, gosh, I went there. I think it was a quarterback mistake. When two guys go the same way and one guy goes the other way, you better blame the one guy.
And now, the Buckeyes better keep an eye on the two tight ends. Cross and Tintley. Rogers, off a fake, drops back, throws! Incomplete!
Dropped it.
Nick Bell had it for a moment and couldn't hang on.
But there was good play action. They had Bell over here, and here's Bell. They're going to run action toward him, see, like this, and then they run him right down the seam. Quarterback came out and tried to throw back, hit him in a bad place, the hands. See, here it is, little bootleg action. He comes out. There's Bell working down the seam. There he is, right between the safeties. There it is. He's got to make that catch, and he normally does.
A field goal The Hawkeyes faked one for a touchdown last week in Champaign, but ahead by three in a tough defensive game, they'll settle for a 37-yard field goal by Jeff Skillett and a six-point lead. Iowa 20, Ohio State 14. And I guess they're going to turn this one over to the Hawkeye defense.
I tell you, both defensive teams are playing pretty well right now. They really are.
Dick, now your feeling about a possible Iowa-Washington matchup.
Well, I'd say Washington would have to be favored, Brent. In watching them play, I think they have a little more overall team speed, especially on defense, and they can make the big plays on offense just like Iowa does. And they have the advantage of being in their on the West Coast the whole time and not having to work here for a while then travel out there. I think Washington would be favored.
Saw a flash of that early field goal by Kansas against Nebraska. That's a former Ohio State assistant coach who is now the head coach there, Glenn Mason. He's coaching Kansas, and that one, of course, is very early. Nebraska, in case you were not with Roger Twible, at halftime appears headed for the Citrus Bowl and a possible meeting with Georgia Tech. The Ramblin' Wreck with one ACC game left, and that's Wake Forest next week. And it looks as though six Big Ten teams are going to go bowling this year, including Indiana, which is aimed at the Peach Bowl. Skillett kicking it off, and Benote is back deep for the Buckeyes. And this is Lee. For an alley. Oh. Out to the 41. Great return by Dante Lee before Jason Olenzak can whack him down.
Here is the return. Now, this guy's a little quick guy, and he has that good feet. Now, what by good feet, I mean, see him chopping me. He can move him. He can step around people. But what a nice hit by Jason, number 13. That one's smarted.
Should be Friday the 13th. Jason's unloading on you. First and 10 for the Buckeyes. It's 20-14. They trail it. Closing seconds here of the third quarter. No daylight because of Jeff Nelson, number 93. And that's going to bring the third quarter to an end. We're going to return with more college football action featuring Ohio State against Iowa after this message and a word from our ABC station. The way it ought to be in Iowa. Natural grass, the wave of the future in the Big Ten. Ohio State tore up its rug. Michigan soon will do the same. Perhaps only the Dome in Minneapolis will wind up with a carpet before long. Fry on the roll, almost picked off by number 19. That was Gary Clark who stepped in.
You know, a safety coming from an inside-out position can make that play a little easier when the quarterback is rolling and pulling you in that direction, so you're running in the same direction the quarterback is pulling you, and it's a little easier to pick that ball off.
How about the tip balls?
Yeah.
Hurries and the sacks, they have been all over Greg Fry, especially here in the second half. He's 1 of 11 for 20 yards in this half, coach.
But they did do the good thing. They got him outside the rush on that rollout.
Deep drop. He won't get out. Yes, he does as he's going down into the arms of Jeff Nelson, and it's an incompleted pass.
There was more than one guy there involved in the pressure, but Jess Nelson was the final sack man. He had two sacks coming into the ball game. We'll show you the pressure here. It originates right there. Jeff Nelson, he's an electrical engineering student. This time he's going to light up the quarterback. Good rush. He just keeps on coming. See, he just keeps on coming. Relentless rush. Good job by him.
Bowman. Bluffing the fair catch. It'll go through the end zone and come out of the
Romans.
59 yards.
I love for the Fox, Hayden Fry, to come up with one of his exotics. We haven't had one since the first series of down, and it was the big play in the scoring drive. Come on, Hayden, you'll lose your reputation.
The dean of the Big Ten coaches, with Bo Schembechler having retired, and Bo, many years ago, said it was Hayden who came into the Big Ten and changed the image of the Big Two in the Little Eight. You really turned things around there.
I was talking to him about the tight calls on fourth down and all that kind of stuff, and he said when the quarterback comes over to me on those fourth and one calls, I always tell him, you call it. Your scholarship's longer than my contract.
There's a familiar Iowa name.
You bet. Hartley.
19 bending down. That's Jimmy Hartley, Chuck's brother. He has been signaling in the offensive plays to Matt Rogers. This is the toss to Stewart. Student body right here in the Midwest. And Vinny Clark tackling it.
See, that's what I was talking about earlier, Brent. They've constricted the defense. They've got him playing those butt techniques up inside. Go ahead and stretch him now. Get him outside. Then come with your reverse game because they have him. I asked Tony Stewart, number 21, where he wanted to play and which team. And he said, just the NFL, coach. Any one of them, it'll take me. And he will. He'll be a good one.
Second down. Stewart tackled short of the first down. A penalty flag comes flying, and while they sort this penalty out, let's check in with Roger Twivel on a Penn State update. Raj?
Thank you very much, Brent. Maryland Penn State tied at 10 at halftime. First possession, third quarter, Tony Sacca finds David Daniels. Look at the catch here. 30 yards on the touchdown reception, 17-10 Penn State. Penn State, of course, next week against Notre Dame. And speaking of the Irish, Tennessee on their first possession with a field goal. They lead it 3-0. Brent.
Oh, they love that score here in Iowa. That's part of the scenario that would move the Hawkeyes up a little bit. It was a face mask penalty, as Coach Vermeil told you. I believe it was Tovar who was assessed at 15 yards. So the ball is moved out to the Iowa 42-yard line. Hawkeyes are up by 6, 20-14. Gently, the stand-up tight end over to Rogers' left. And Stewart, straight up the middle. Another first down and 11 more yards.
Focus your attention now on Stewart as he goes through. You'll see, follow his feet, what he does. He keeps him always in a position that he can cut and move. Watch him. See how his feet are apart? He's sort of dancing through there, keeps him clean, never long strided, always together and bouncing one way or the other. That's why he can run in those intense areas.
First and 10. The ball at the Buckeye, 48-yard line, and Notre Dame quickly jumps ahead of the Volunteers. Stewart on a splendid cutback. First down. 13 more yards for Stewart inside the 35.
They're getting real good pursuit. Watch out for the reverse.
Mark, how about this young man, Stewart?
Well, guys, Tony Stewart has a tattoo of a tiger with a rose in its mouth on his left calf. I asked him why a tiger with a rose in its mouth. He said he loves tigers. They're strong, they're fast, and they dominate. I asked him about the rose. He said he didn't want to say anything until after the season. I think it has something to do, though, with the Rose Bowl, fellas. What do you think?
Mark, that's not a tiger. That's a husky. Here is Stewart again. With the rose on his leg, he's tattooed out of bounds that time by Foster Falk.
By number 22.
12:43 to go here.
You know, it's amazing what the operations are performed now and on the knees. You know, years ago, if a running back had a serious knee injury, he probably never played again, but now they come back and play. The big thing is the rehabilitation process.
There's Hartlieb on the sideline, sending in the play. Hayden Fry, for all intents and purposes, is truly his own offensive coordinator. He makes the decisions, and they get passed along.
Audible to it. He saw a double zone. He's going to try to work down inside of the man.
Hit from behind and incomplete. Great defensive effort that time by Brian Cook. So the defensive back coming on the blitz makes it 3rd and 9.
You'll see he's going to get some pressure on this from the lower left-hand corner. Here he comes. Coming to the outside. He's not accounted for. gets right on around the outside, and there's Cook, and he gets him around the back and just grabs his arm. And I'll tell you, sometimes that can really hurt the quarterback's throwing arm.
Third and nine. Hawkeyes need to get the ball to the 23-yard line for the first down. Lead it by six. Even another Iowa field goal would be big here.
Oh, big hole for Montgomery. Blast to the 20-yard line. There's that play again, Coach.
Yeah, they took the fullback up in there quick. I'm not so sure if they trapped it or not. Here's a low-end shot taken at it. Now, you be the linebackers, ladies and gentlemen. You're sitting there on the couch. You make the play. Here it is. Make it. Oh, you didn't want to make the tackle either, did you? Here he is, wide open. That was a trap play. Trap play meaning they blocked, pulled a man from one side of the center, and trapped across the hole.
Nine carries for 58 yards. The backs are split this time. They'll run Stewart on that draw play. He hammers to the 14-yard line. It'll be second and short as the result of a good run. And Iowa's ground game beginning now to wear the Buckeyes down a bit.
You know, Stewart's just a few, couple hundred yards away from the all-time rushing record here.
Take a listen to this hit as Park was shaken up on the play. Here's the replay.
Ooh, helmet to helmet. Wow. He'll be back. Good young player. It's a sophomore. Sarasota, Florida, Riverview High School. Had three starts last year.
Excuse me, there's a lot of Ohio State fans down in Florida. Sarasota, Miami, yeah.
Yeah, they get some good football players out of there. They go down there and recruit speed.
Okay.
Stemming the tight end over.
And they run Stewart back to the short side. Out of bounds at the 6-yard line. Bellini taking him out of bounds, or he might have split into the end zone.
Well, see, he bent all the way back against the pressure of the defense. You'll see it from the end zone here. He starts to one side, and he bends it all the way back because the defensive end collapses too much, doesn't have any contain. See, now watch him bend it all the way back here. See, he's pressuring that defense. There's Spellman fighting hard on that limpy and gimpy ankle.
First and goal. Spellman hanging tough with that gimpy ankle. Hughes coming in motion behind Rogers. Stewart straight ahead and blasts his way toward that end zone.
Wait, Steve Tovar, number 58, hit him. But Tony Stewart, number 21, had a head of steam.
Stewart deserves to get the call this time, doesn't he?
Hey, when you have a running
yards, 14 carries.
You're right, Brent. When you have a running back that's hot, give him the ball. Taking a look at that ball 22. It's a fullback kick out back, block, tailback here, offside guard pulled, blocking here. Take a good look at it now. Very well designed to get the double team. There's the fullback on the kick out. We're back to action.
Montgomery goes in for the offside. Touchdown.
Same play that took him down to the 1 foot line. A good double, a good kick out block. Now, good contact. He got his pads down. Stovar is trying to stop him from getting in the end zone. He does it. Now, here's the touchdown.
Montgomery with 59 yards and two touchdowns, and Iowa will go for two, leading 26-14 with 11 minutes to go. They'll go for two, Dick.
Normally, I think they like to get some kind of an option on this play. They've been successful two for two. Here's the option. Reverse
back to Hughes. Hughes is trapped, and they will not get it. 26-14 as the two-point play fails, and the Hawkeyes will kick it off. Lance Price and Rich Frimmel deserve credit for stopping that two-point attempt. But the Hawkeyes are ahead and inching closer and closer to Pasadena. New Year's Day. We'll be right back. we'll see that next one if Tommy Maddox can solve that tough Washington defense. Here, Iowa ahead. And Skillet kicks it off. Fielded at the 6 by Benote for the 20. Out to the 29-yard line. This is a day that Iowa could clinch a tie for the Big Ten championship, and the scenario is unfolding in their direction. They're ahead. Illinois is losing to Michigan 22-17, and Michigan State has jumped ahead of Minnesota 7-0. So everything is coming up roses for the Hawkeyes here this afternoon. 10:57 to go now in the game. And Ohio State badly in need of another one of those ricochet big plays.
They have their young offensive line in on the strong side right now, and Rod Smith, a redshirt freshman, and Winrow, a freshman, both over 300 pounds.
Fly on first down, throws complete to the 35-yard line. And Lukovich, the tight end, was the receiver that time, with Tennessee kicking its second field goal to make that up 1 point.
They have a tremendous number of young, talented players in this Ohio State program. Right now, I think there's only two seniors on the field offensively.
But not a conference game. Will not affect Georgia Tech's bid for the Citrus Bowl. So Jeff Graham in motion. Greg Fry rolling. Now going for the bomb and incomplete. Stabline, the wide receiver, complaining that he was interfered with inside the 15-yard line.
That was good pattern design. They ran a man in motion, and it forced a safety to be covering a wide receiver in a man-to-man situation. Now you'll see him coming down and getting on the safety, number 15, Brian Wise. You like that kind of a matchup, a safety against a wide receiver. He's normally in positions to cover tight ends. He has the step, but it's just a little overthrown. And not bad coverage either. We'll take the perfect throw.
There was a penalty flag, but not the one Stabline wanted. It was back at the line of scrimmage.
You're going to call hugging or holding?
Holding.
Holding.
Offense. Receive second down.
It has been uphill for the Buckeyes.
Give it to him, Coop. He ain't going to listen to you anyway, but give it to him.
Already had an unsportsmanlike penalty call on that far sideline.
You got to get after him once in a while. See, the officials go home on Monday and make a living doing something else.
10:15 left here in Kinnick Stadium, Iowa City. Fly, rolling to the left, cut off. He's going to throw back to Robert Smith on the screen here on the near side, and Smith is out of bounds at the 31-yard line.
Clever play. It looked like it was going to be much bigger play from up here. Good speed by the defense. You'll see that they're going to fake here like this, and then he'll sneak out and come in the screen and get his offensive lineman over here to the right. See, now he's going to fake it. Now he fakes it to him. He picks up a little block there. Now look at him get off it. He comes in the screen, just like he's coached to do. He gets in the screen wall. It appears there's a lot of room, but good pursuit.
And Foster, the linebacker, doing a good job. Backside protection that time. Five. Running back split. Straight back. Sacked again. Matt Rulin, number 57.
I think that's his third sack on the day, and he came into the game with only four. Excellent job by Matt Rulin. He is fired up. He is fired up. You can see Foster, 66, dropping out of there. Running back getting out of the pattern. He said it's taken away, and then here he comes. He beat Lenny Hartman, number 52.
Bowman.
Nice punt.
Hits it at the 13. And Tula driven back inside Iowa's 25. And the return is out to the 33. 9:15, and the Hawkeyes leading it 26-14. The penalty marker being sorted out on that far side.
I don't know how many we've had today, but there's too many.
against the receiving team. So we'll take a break. And when you come back, it'll be the Hawkeyes 26 and the Buckeyes 14.
Illegal use of hands. On the return.
With Dick Vermeil and Mark Jones, I'm Brent Musburger. That's the time remaining. And you can see how the Hawkeyes have dominated this one. Their magical, mystical tour of the Big Ten continues. Who would have thought this possible when the season began? Most experts predicting Iowa would wind up in the middle of the pack. Now the only unbeaten team in the conference. They go to work on the clock with Tony Stewart operating a tailback. It's out to the 25, and Herman tackling him there for the Buckeyes.
Judah Herman did a nice job of holding his position backside and keeping the ball just slightly in front of him, so if it did come back, he was there in position to make the play. Good discipline by Judah Herman.
No team in the history of the Big Ten has ever beaten Michigan, Michigan State, Illinois, and Ohio State in the same year. And Iowa forced to do it the hard way. This their lone home game. Sequence. Jay Cook making the stop for the Buckeyes. And here is a man, Dick, who has really played a whale of a game, Lou Montgomery.
Well, you know why USA Today picked him as the state player of the year coming out of high school. Waterloo, Iowa. He's a good football player.
He has not met his Waterloo here this afternoon. Third down and two. Man, Waterloo used to be a tough place for me to umpire and coach.
You umpired, huh?
Yeah. All these Iowa and Illinois towns. Rogers coming around the right side toward that first down marker. You know, Simmons tackling him.
Did you see that option play? The very first option play ever run in a college football game was run against Ohio State in 1941. Don Faro at the University of Missouri designed the play, got the idea from watching a basketball practice. When they ran a fast break, a 2-and-1, he applied that principle to a quarterback being in a 2-and-1 situation with a running back and flip it to him, put it in his offense, ran it against Ohio State. Paul Brown coach football team. Hey, a little trivia for you.
Yes, it is. I didn't know that.
Yeah, learn something every day. Stick by me.
You've been studying a little bit.
You know what happened, though? His two assistants in the Navy team he coached here in Iowa, the Seahawk Navy team, during the Second World War with Bud Wilkinson. Okay. Bud Wilkinson took it to Oklahoma. Made it famous because he recruited a little better.
Yeah, like about 47 straight times he made it famous, I guess.
But really, that's how the option. It came off the basketball floor, the original idea.
Well, on fourth and short, Hayden Fry not in the mood to gamble. Isaac onto the field. Low snap. Buckeye block it. The block punt. And it'll be Ohio State ball. It's picked up by Iowa. Chance for the first down. They fumble it. And the Buckeyes finally pick it up, and it'll be whistled dead. It'll be whistled dead back at the 45-yard line.
Blocked.
That was Foster Polk, number 22, who blocked that punt. But a Hawkeye alertly picked it up and saved some valuable yardage. Olenzak is the Iowa player who scooped it up.
All right, I think the rusher came from right here. Foster Polk, number 22. I think he came underneath. There it is, coming underneath. No, it was the next man to the inside. It was a low snap. Still had enough time to get it off if you blocked that properly. That's the first block punt on the season for Jim Hysack. Here's another look at it. I'll tell you, when you get a punt block, it's always disastrous. There's the low snap. See, now that took him much longer to get the ball off. You want to get that punted in about 2 seconds. He could not do it in that situation.
And the ball could not be advanced beyond the 24. The Buckeyes will put it in play there, first and 10. Robert Smith hit at the 21-yard line by Rod Davis. We can't say enough about the interior of this Iowa defense here this afternoon. Number 54, Rod Davis, is hanging tough with 57, Matt Ruland, and 71, Jim Johnson. They have played a whale of a game on the interior of this hand-holding defense here this afternoon. Wouldn't that be a shocker? Second down. Still plenty of time left at 6:47.
Audible's checking out.
5 seconds left to get it off. Fly, rolling to the right. Batted ball again. Derby, number 31.
That is Derby's second batted ball. You'll remember we mentioned that. Now, he was audibling because of the defense he saw. He didn't like the run that he had called. He changed it. He thought he was going to get one-on-one situation. You see the quarterback. Audible to the right. He audibling to the right. Gives the signal. Now he turns to the left. Normally, yes, he gives the signal. Make sure everybody's known. Still didn't get it done. Good job on defense by Derby.
It is third down and 7 yards for the Buckeyes. They have to get to the 13-yard line for a first down.
I'd look for some pressure coming here now. I don't think they'll drop off play. Yeah, they're going to come back. They're coming after him.
Trying to get him fry. Touchdown! Hits Olive at the goal line, and he backs into the end zone. Big play again for Ohio State, Coach.
Outside receiver of a slot formation. The inside receiver controls the safety, gets one-on-one on the corner. He throws to the left of your screen, the post pattern. Here he comes back, sets up, five-step drop, fires it. You'll note no safety inside him. He was controlled by the slot man. Excellent catch again by Bobby Allen. He's had a whale of a game.
Down by six, they'll go for the one in this situation. Hoping to close to within five. And that sets up some drama here at Iowa City. 5-point game. Iowa 26, Ohio State 21. 6.5 minutes to play. Over the last 23 meetings, Ohio State has beaten Iowa 20 times, lost twice, and tied one. And if you're an Iowa backer, you've got to be just a touch nervous because of that history right now. Hughes and Antula are back deep. Williams to kick it off for the Buckeyes. 6.5 minutes to go. Hughes at the pitch. Down at the 23-yard line, where it will be 1st and 10, Coach, in a huge series for Iowa.
Again, taking a look at that touchdown pass. The slot receiver here went down and went to the post, and that froze the safety just enough to allow Bobby Olive to go inside and not get any help from the defender. He went in on Merton Hanks. You'll see this as we go now. Now watch the safety at the top of your screen freeze on that post. See, take those pedal moves to the inside, and there it is. The little things make a difference. Here's another look. See him freeze his safety? Now his single outside. Merton Hanks goes to bat it down, didn't make it.
As the result, it's a 5-point lead. Rogers on first down, throws to Montgomery at the 25. Montgomery out to the 31-yard line. And for an update, let's check in with Roger Twybel. Roger?
Yeah. Well, Brent, we're about 25 minutes from kickoff in Seattle. Second-ranked Washington will take on UCLA. Greg Lewis, of course, 137 yards a game, rushing 8 touchdowns this year. And he has rushed for over 100 yards in every game this year. The only other Pac-10 back to do that all season was Marcus Allen. Now, I want to update you on a score right now. Virginia Tech, with a 22-yard field goal by Mickey Thomas, leads Georgia Tech with 8 minutes left in that game. Brent.
All right, here it's 26-21. Iowa with a 5-point lead and 5:48 to go. Nick Bell, the ball carrier, and Steve Tovar hitting him defensively, but it was good for the first down for the Hawkeyes. The chains move, and what Hayden Fry wants in this situation is a ball control drive that results in a touchdown. What John Cooper wants on the far sideline is either a defensive turnover or 3 quick downs and an out. Ohio State, remember, used a timeout very early in the second half. They are down to 2 right now. Rogers hands to Bell, and he makes his way to the 40-yard line, where it'll be 2nd down and 5.
Bell doesn't look, to me today, as crisp as he looked on tape last week against Illinois. To me, as I look down in the field, Stewart has been the guy that supplied the spark on all the running plays. I'd go back to Stewart. You know, you have good days and bad days.
Or hand the ball to the fullback, Montgomery.
He doesn't look like he's flashing today, does he, you?
No, he looks like he's trying to read daylight.
Yeah.
Oh, to break it down. Rodgers to throw it.
Got a broken play if he throws.
Throws
it.
Down the middle. Oh, intercepted by number one Lance Price. The Buckeyes with a chance here. 4.5 minutes to go, and Price gives Ohio State the turnover they've been looking for.
Way too much time. First, you never throw the ball late down the middle. You just never do that. And this young man hasn't done it. Like you said, he hadn't thrown an interception in the Big Ten the last four games coming into here. See, too much time. Now he throws it late down the middle. Cardinal sin of quarterback. All right, now you got to suck it up, defense. Good job by Ohio State's defense.
First and 10, Ohio State. Ball at the Iowa 44. 4.5 minutes. 5-point Iowa lead. Graham in motion. Fly to throw on first down. Over the middle, complete to Lanhoos. Whacked at the 30-yard line. But it's another Ohio State first down.
Good play action. You'll notice Fry comes out to make the play action fake. He extends the ball. He wants everybody to see it. See him extend it out there? Now he takes it, puts it on the hip, has a crossing pattern. He's frozen the linebackers. He throws it. Here it is. Now watch the hit. Wham! But Bobby Olive's the player of the game for Ohio State today. He's really playing well.
Four catches, 73 yards for number 8. Ball at the Iowa 30. Robert Smith. Down at the 26-yard line.
I've seen Greg Fry so many times play. If I were his coach, I would have great confidence in him at this time. I've seen him come back and beat LSU on final plays and rally him against Michigan when they're out of it by 27, 28 points. He just seems to rise to that occasion.
Olive back into the game, as is Dante Lee.
Boy, this is gut check time for Iowa defense.
3.5 minutes to go. Buckeyes on the move and trailing it by 5. Twists up probably down at the 35.
Again, trying to run the option to the short side of the formation, the split end side. You'll see what I mean. The pressure appears quickly. He fakes to the fullback. He comes off the fake. See, he's going to come off the fake, and bang, here comes the pressure right now. He doesn't have time. Good job by Jimmy Johnson, number 71. You can see why he was all Big Ten last year. Sacks, 3 sacks, 6 hurries, 6 3-tip balls. Boy, that was a big, big play by Johnson.
Third down and 15. Drop. Looks to the middle, incomplete. Ohio State down to its fourth down. And again, it was number 31, John Derby.
He is a player, isn't he? You know, he came here as a running back. He ran 1,780 yards, 30 touchdowns. And he's playing linebacker. No wonder he's a good linebacker. I think we're going to be able to see the tip here. Now, Derby was lined up to the left of your screen. Now he's going to flash in. And here he comes. Here he comes. See him flashing in here. Watching the quarterback side. That's the third time today he has batted a pass. Outstanding defense by Derby. No wonder the coach was excited about him the other day.
Ohio State had to use another timeout. The 25-second clock down to 4 seconds. And this will bring the Buckeyes to their last timeout. For all intents and purposes, this game is coming down to one play when you return. Fourth down and 16 yards for Ohio State. The ball is at the Iowa 34-yard line. They need to get to the 18. Edwards is in the slot. To the quarterback's left. Fly under pressure. Steps away from it. Throws to the goal line. Intercepted by Iowa.
Ryan Wise. No, that was Jason.
Ah! dangerous moment for the Hawkeyes here with 2.5 minutes to go. And Cooper talking to Benny Clark.
Well, Ohio State has to just now just think about getting pressure on him. Just come after him, try to create the turnover, stunt inside, just get after him.
Here's Stewart. Second and 10.
Taking a look at this from all 22 now, you'll see to the right side of your screen is the safety, Jason, number 13. Olenzak, that makes the play, gets back there. He's just sitting in the hole waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting. Here comes the crossing pattern. There he is. He goes up after the ball, catches it at his highest points just like he's coached to. Jason Olenzak, a pre-med student. Smart young man playing safety, and he played that ball nicely. Up for his highest point.
Nobody ever operated any slicker than Olenzak did on that play right there.
He did a nice job.
Inside of 2 minutes now, and Iowa will try to hold on to that football. Stewart down at the 15-yard line. Ohio State with only one timeout to go. 1:39 to go.
Ohio State is still going to get the ball back. On the sideline, they've got to be organized, really getting their hurry-up offense all set, squared away is exactly what they're going to do.
I know many of you are shocked that Northwestern didn't accomplish that. Minute 19. Third down and 15 yards. The final timeout, and now how those two other timeouts loom so important for John Cooper. In this situation, wouldn't you go all out and try to block the punt if they
got anything
to lose? Oh,
yeah. They've already done it once. They've already done it once. Go ahead. You're going to get the ball back. Iowa State has no timeouts. Ohio State, rather, excuse me.
You're taking his Cyclones timeouts away, too.
Yeah, taking him around, too. He's going to make a mistake, make a big one. What the heck?
Well, a reminder that at the conclusion of today's game, we'll select a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player from each team for the 20th year through the Chevrolet Scholarship Program. $1,000 will be donated to the General Scholarship Fund of each school. Hope you've enjoyed it, and regardless of what happens here this afternoon, next Saturday's game between Purdue and Iowa will be a big one for that man, Hayden Fry. Steve Breaux is the long snapper. And that will follow us as soon as this one ends. Isaac standing inside the five, and contact made in the line. A five-yard penalty will not give Iowa a first down.
See now, Brent, that long snap should get back to the punter in 8/10 of a second. The punter will have 1.2 seconds to get it off. They get it off in that rhythm, it should not be blocked.
So the ball is marched off to the 21-yard line. A minute 4 to go. Jeff Graham, a big play man, standing back near midfield. The ghosts of Ohio State past trying to haunt Iowa one more time. He gets off a low one. Fair catch at the 49, and the clock is stopped with 59 seconds. But sideline patterns are the order of the day. They'll have to get the clock stopped.
See, the big thing now with the sideline patterns, the defense will be designed to keep everything inside. Keep everything inside. They'll throw the ball up inside. They don't have the timeout, so they've got to hurry up and get it. The one thing, if they do get the 10-yard gain, the clock will stop as they move the chains. That's one of them.
Edwards, Graham, and Olive are the wide receivers. The offensive line. On the run, throws complete. Once he goes down and they move the chains, now the clock is stopped at 50 seconds, but they'll have to hurry. They are down to the 25-yard line.
Leroy Smith came in from the backside. They better get him blocked because he's all over him.
Clock can be stopped this year by a college quarterback throwing it straight down. He's restarted. Fly pulls out, again complete, and that is short of the first down. The chains were not completely moved on the far side. Clock continues to move. Ohio State out of timeouts.
30 seconds. 29.
Second down. And 3 yards for a first down. Fly. Incomplete. Stops the clock with 20 seconds to go. So, Vermeil, you be the coach.
Let me breathe.
What happens now?
I'm excited, coach. Oh, my God. Jimmy Coletto right there in the middle. He's going to make the decision along with Cooper and Coach Huey right there. Here's the reaction that last play. Don't bite too deep, Coop.
It has been a nail biter here in Iowa City.
It has been an ending.
Third and three. The ball is at the 18. 20 seconds to go. Graham, Edwards, and Olive. Talented wide receivers. Graham, first and goal at the 2. Clock stops with 13. Buckeyes with a chance to win it. 13 seconds to go. Now the clock starts. Scotty Graham and Robert Smith. The fade, incomplete, stops it with 7 seconds to go.
You know, if he'd have thrown that fade pattern a little more accurately at that time, he might have had it. Oh, Coach Hayden. Hayden Fry. You see what I mean? Take a look at this. If this fade was thrown perfectly, he had a shot at making the reception to the left-hand side of your receiver. He's out there in good position.
Ohio State will operate with a tight end. We're at the 3-yard line. Timeouts. Fly to throw. Touchdown, Ohio State. Olive. With 1 second on the clock, the Buckeyes haunt Iowa one more time. Hayden Fry. With Olive catching his second touchdown pass of the game. The jubilant Buckeyes. 27-26. Ohio State up by a point.
You can see they come with their basic play-action pass. Olive was the outside man outside the slot. He came inside. The slot man went outside. He hit him right where he had to. Way out in front. He dove for the football. Excellent execution in a pressure situation. Again, Greg Fry coming up with the play. He needed to get it.
And from the far side, Cooper's reaction.
Watch out for your back, Coop. I wish I could describe that feeling. I have been there. It is a gut-wrencher.
That back is completely healed. And for that man, the agony of coming so close. And now the Hawkeyes will have to reload, because what this means is that Iowa must beat Purdue and Minnesota. Now, if they do, they will stay a half game ahead of Ohio State, because Buckeye fans must remember the Indiana game. That was the one they tied. Ohio State has lost already to Illinois, so they have a loss and a tie. This would be the Hawkeyes' first loss. And so no one still has been able to accomplish that. But remember, the ball is live on an extra point, and who knows? Maybe there's time for one last miracle here in Kinnick Stadium.
You go back to the block punt. If you get a punt blocked in a football game, it is normally a disaster, especially if the two teams are pretty evenly matched. And I really think the best football team today was Iowa. But the best football team doesn't always win.
High marks to Cooper and the Buckeyes for never surrendering here.
You bet.
They're going to run. They'll sit on the snap, so an extra point run back cannot be made. They do not want to put the ball in play. That's why they elected to kill it right there. Because of the rule, if the extra point had been blocked, it would have been a live ball, and Iowa could have run it back for the tying point. So one and two are not really different.
Well, there's been a lot of pressure on Coach Cooper. You know, in Ohio State football, you're evaluated every day on every week, and you're only as good as your last game. This should take a little of the heat off him because he's done a good job there, and they are a very young football team. In fact, both of these football teams are still very young football teams.
A crusher for Hayden Fry and the Hawkeyes. Now he must get his team ready for Purdue, which comes in here next week. And then on the last Saturday of the regular season, another nemesis awaits Iowa, and that's Minnesota.
He'll bring him back. Hayden will bring him back. You know what he's doing right now? He's thinking about that last series he had the ball and didn't make the first down. Did I call the right things? Why did I call? I should have done this. You start second-guessing everything you did on those three series, and it drives you crazy. You can stay in coaching when you can turn those thoughts off 2 days later. The reason I'm standing next to you 10 days later is I'm still thinking about what I should have done on third down.
Because of the celebration, the penalty is assessed here on the kickoff. So the ball is moved all the way back to the 20-yard line. And so, oh, now, if Iowa just had a trombone player from Stanford standing down in that end zone. Oh, what I wouldn't give for the band, they're saying, marching out here in the last second. We may set a new record for laterals on this kickoff. A bouncer. And Tula at the 30. Lateral man, number one. Number two to Hughes. Hughes,
forward.
There's the flag. That's forward. There's number four. And he's
up. All forward pass.
There's five. Over his head and out.
Yeah, all four laterals.
And John Cooper and the Buckeyes win a big one. Aiden Fry graciously congratulating Coach Cooper. Buckeyes are still in the driver's seat, but not as much breathing room. On the last play from scrimmage, beating Iowa 27-26. And the Chevrolet most valuable players of this game are Bobby Olive, who caught the game winner for the Buckeyes, and John Derby, the outstanding linebacker from Iowa, six tackles and three tip passes. And Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements. As the result of this upset by Ohio State, Iowa loses for the first time, and now to get to Pasadena must beat Purdue at home next Saturday and then Minnesota in the Twin Cities on the last Saturday of the regular season. Ohio State pulling for a tie or a defeat in either of those two games, and the Buckeyes could still be headed to Pasadena. So for Mark Jones and Dick Vermeil, I'm Brett Musburger, reminding you that coming up next, it's Washington against UCLA on ABC.
Coming up, it's a Pac-10 matchup.
the UCLA Bruins take on the conference champion number 2 Washington, live next as ABC's College Football continues. ABC's College Football has been brought to you by Today's Chevrolet, who invites you to see why more people are winning with the heartbeat of America, and by USF&G Insurance, protecting your business, home, auto, and life. USF&G, standing behind the USA. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.